I'm Sharon Maclis at IDG Communications, here with Do More with R, episode 58, Email from R, including graphics. How do you share your R work with others? R Markdown is one good way because it's easy to mix text narrative, calculation results, and graphics. But how do you share your R Markdown documents with colleagues? You can post them somewhere, email them as attachments, or you can turn an R Markdown document into an email message and send it in the body of your email right from R, ggplot graphs included. That's thanks to the Blastula package from R Studio. Here's how it works. First, not surprisingly, install and load Blastula. It's on CRAN. There are two ways to create an email with Blastula. My favorite is to start with an R Markdown document. Use email as the output format. Make sure to include a title and you're ready to go. The other way is to use Blastula's compose email function, which is a bit more manual. I'll use R Markdown. So I suggest creating an empty document. In R Studio, we'll go to File, New File, R Markdown, and then click on Create Empty Document. Here's what you want at the top, a title and the email output format. Then create an R Markdown document as usual. Here's a little sample. Can use usual format. Can even use some HTML CSS inline if I want. And a ggplot graph. Note that HTML widgets won't work here. Emails won't run JavaScript, but ggplot works fine. You can preview what this looks like the usual way by clicking the knit button in R Studio. And there it is, including my graph. You'll want to save this to a Blastula email object with the package's render underscore email function. I'm loading Blastula. I'm saving that R Markdown to an email object. And let's check what that is. It's a Blastula message, email message type of object. You can also preview the email object with print. And you see it shows up in the bottom right panel of R Studio. So now it's time to send an email. To do this, you need access to an SMTP server. Outlook, Gmail, and a lot of other email services use SMTP. But to use Blastula, you'll need to have access to send mail programmatically through that server. Depending on security settings, you may not, especially at work. If you're using a personal Gmail account, you need to set your account to allow what Google considers less secure apps to access your account. I would not recommend doing this for a primary Google account that has sensitive information. But I have a secondary Google account I use for a hobby local neighborhood event site, which I haven't really used in more than a year now, thanks to the pandemic. So that's a good one for a demo. To change your settings, you need to go to Manage your Google account and then Security, and then scroll down to where it says less secure apps access, which sounds alarming. I clicked on here when it was off to turn it on. I'm not going to do it again because it's going to send me yet more warnings, but you will get a warning on your email saying that you've done something alarming, and it will show a little warning icon here when you have it done. I can save my Gmail username and Gmail server settings with Blastula's create underscore SMTP underscore creds underscore key function. Here's the format. This saves your username and provider server settings, but not your password. That's for better security. You'll need to enter your password with this command. I already ran it for my account. When I did, I got this message. Let me show you. I saved it for you. It's telling me that when I'm ready to send, I should use credentials equal creds underscore key and then Gmail. Okay, time to test it out. Here's the format for the SMTP underscore send function. Start with the email object, include a from, a to, a subject, and then your credentials, as it said in the message, creds underscore key, and then my Gmail stored. Okay, I'm going to run that and send it to test Do More with R account. So look at the account is here. You can see I'm going to refresh and there's nothing here. Let's go back to R and try to send my email. It says it was sent successfully. Let's take a look. And there it is. And you can see I've got all the formatting here and my graph. An easy way to share our analysis with others. That's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the Do More With R page at bit.ly/domorewithr, all lowercase except for the R. You can also find the Do More With R playlist on YouTube's IDG Tech Talk channel, where you can subscribe so you never miss an episode. Hope to see you next time. Stay healthy and safe, everyone.